Alright, so this is just going to be a quick little tip for loudizzzle especially, but I guess it could apply to everyone, but it's more specifically for loudizzzle. He was having trouble finding locations to drill into or bolt into the frame for his frame ground. I'm making this to show you that you don't need to do that. You don't need to bolt into the frame and drill a new hole into the frame. The reason is, as you can see right here, I have my ground post. And you can see the zero gauge, right, all the black zero gauge, but right here is one small little wire with two black wires attached to it that are much smaller, and as you can probably tell, that's the factory ground. That's the ground that came with the vehicle, and the reason there's two wires is because one of them goes under the battery tray here and is connected to the vehicle wall, or the front wall of the chassis under the tray. So that's the first chassis ground that is from the stock harness. So what we did is we took this zero gauge right here and added it to the ground location where this harness was grounded to, and simply did not screw in the stock chassis ground that's from this harness. It's just taped up and dangling down there because it's now replaced with the zero gauge one. And then there's another wire coming off of here, and that one goes down under that hose right here, goes under there, and what's under there is the frame. And I can't get the camera down in there, but there's a bolt coming out of the frame with a nut on the top of it, and that is what, let's see if I can, what this one right here goes down and connects to. Now unfortunately we don't have all the zero gauge to replace that one, so we're still waiting on the big bundle of zero gauge to be able to replace it. So that's why we still have this factory ground here. But all you need to do, loudizzzle, is take your factory ground and follow it to its locations where it's grounded to your vehicle already, and simply replace those with your big three wires. So what I've done is I've got one chassis ground right here, a second chassis ground right here, my engine block ground right there, and then since I don't have the zero gauge to do it yet, I have to just make do with that right now for my frame ground. And then in the back, I have the battery grounded to the frame as well, and then the second battery grounded to that battery. So I hope that helps out a bit and shows you a little bit about grounding, and that you don't need to bolt into a new location or drill any new holes into your frame or chassis, and that if you follow your stock harness, you should be able to find the locations fairly easy. So I hope that
helps.
Another
thing I'm going to be doing soon is, thanks to someone else who has a Blazer or a Jimmy, I can't remember, and I can't remember your name on YouTube, sorry, but he notified me about these little vent holes that line up with these black things on the back hatch when it's closed. But it lets a lot of air out. If you remove this panel, which I can't get the camera in to show you, unfortunately, maybe I can, but if you remove that panel there, you can access that, and I'm going to access it and cover it with a bunch of fat mat or something, and same with the one over here, because it lets out a lot of your SPL, and I've heard it can increase up to one full decibel if you cover those up. So I'm going to get that done, and yeah, big upgrades, big updates, big surprises coming in April, so stay tuned, everyone.